Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier, and in my this particular video I am going to discuss one very interesting concept related to the labeling of binary object. Okay, so for this particular demonstration purpose I have taken this particular image where you can see there are some rice grains are present in this particular image, and the problem statement is you have to segment the image such that only individual rice particles will be present in each figure window. Okay, so in one image only this particular rice particle will be present, one another image this particular rice particle will be present, in another image this particular rice particle will be present. Okay, and when you are giving that individual rice particles as in different figure window, you need to give only that particular part, not the whole image and where only this particular rice particle is present, not like that. Only the particular region of that particular particle should be given in each figure window. Okay, now pause my video and try to think about one algorithm which can be used to solve this particular problem. Okay, here I am discussing, but please try once by your own and implement the algorithm whatever you are thinking in MATLAB and check whether it is giving correct output or not, because in this way the logical thinking skill will be developed in you. Okay, so what we can do, idea is very simple: label all the images and then take the part, find in the labeled image one particular label is present in which index and crop that particular part, that's all, and show in different figure window, right? And point to be noted here, some holes are present in the binary object, so we can use imfill before applying the labeling. Okay, so here is the code. So what I have done, CLC clear all close all warning off, x equal to im binarize RGB to gray, im read capture JPG. Okay, I am reading the image and I am showing that. So here let me write x equal to im fill x comma holes. Okay, very important, because it will remove all the holes present in the image, and then I am applying labeling on that. Then n is total number of labels, as you know. Okay, so what I am doing, I am traversing that many times for I equal to 1 to n, rc equal to find l equal to I. In our labeled image, that particular label I, which will take value from 1 to n, what are those index where the labeled image is equal to that particular label, those row and column we are extracting. Now we need to crop, so what we will do, we will be taking the minimum of row, maximum of row, minimum of column and maximum of column using this min and max function, and then we will crop from our original image x. Okay, so output equal to x r min colon r max comma c min colon c max, and in figure window I am showing that output. Okay, and in that for loop, using the simple code, you can do this kind of segmentation. And why this is called segmentation? The reason is very simple. Image segmentation means segment your original image into different parts based on certain criteria. That may be anything. Like here in our this particular case, we are just segmenting different objects. Okay, maybe sometime you need to segment based on size, maybe sometime you need to segment border objects and non-border objects, that is segment and make those objects in one figure window which are connected to the border or close to border, and make all the objects which are not connected to the border in separate image. Okay, that is also another kind of segmentation. Segmentation is very important algorithm in image processing and computer vision, that is extracting our own interest part, okay, based on certain algorithms. That is nothing but image segmentation. So now let me show you the output. Just control A and evaluate selection. Here we'll be getting multiple figure window, and figure number of figure window will be equal to number of total rice particles present in this. Okay, so this is our figure 12. Okay, it will take some time, just let me make this. So this is our figure 11, this is figure 10, this is figure 9, this is figure 8, this is figure 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, so see, how many total rice particles present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Total 11. Okay. You can see all the particles, all the alignment that will be matching here. Okay. You can just tally with this particular segmented output. Okay. And see how beautifully we are extracting that. Now, we have applied this algorithm for binary image. Now, let us apply for grayscale image. Okay. And the grayscale image which I am taking for this implementation purpose is present in MATLAB database itself. Okay. So, just first let me run this particular part to close all the previously opened images. And then m equal to imreadcoins.png will known coins image I am taking, which I have already used in many image processing algorithm earlier. Okay. Then we are converting to binary image using global thresholding and filling all the holes. Okay. So I am show m when I will be doing. So I am show x. Let me show you the filled, the hole filling image. Okay. So if I just run this particular part, I'll be getting, this is our original image and this is our hole filled binary image. Okay. Now the same algorithm like earlier, apply labeling and then use for loop. Iterate that many number of times, which is equal to number of labels. Calculate mean max of rows and columns. And now remember, while cropping, take original image. Okay, don't take this binary image, because that is our not point of interest. Our point of interest is segmenting our original image. We have converted to binary for our own requirement of algorithm. But when you are cropping, don't forget to use our original image. Okay, and figure I am show output. That's all. Okay. So for the time being, let me just remove this particular figure window and control A, evaluate selection. Okay. So if I run again, I'll be getting multiple figure window. Okay. So now this is our figure 1. This is our figure 11. This is our figure 10. This is our figure 9. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and this is the last one, which is our 2. Okay, so see how many total coins? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And you can see how many coins here we are getting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 different coins are segmented into 10 different figure window, right? So I hope you have enjoyed this. This is all for this video. Same code will be posted in the description box. If you want, you can check there. Thank you for watching.